Good morning, Twitch.
Hi, Twitch. Okay.
Give you Starfire.
Okay. Hey, everybody. This is Starfire from VR Church. Service is going to start here in a few minutes. So make sure you follow the Twitch, follow all our social medias down below. Everyone here is welcome. And also go to www.vrchurch.org. And, oh, my voice. Okay. She goes to www.vrchurch.org and find our Discord so you can talk to awesome people like me. Also, those in the Twitch chat, please get some emojis and everything up because today is Bishop Soto's birthday. So make sure you hype up. Oh, speaking about Bishop Soto.
Hold up, I gotta get it. All right.
Let me check something real quick. Hold on one second.
Oh no.
Well,
he just tangled his arms.
He took off his headset. But guys, if he comes back, you're gonna sing him a happy birthday, okay?
Howdy.
Sing him a happy birthday. But yeah, guys. Back?
I don't think he's back.
I was throwing in the wall.
Alright. Oh, whoa. Am I in the ground?
One, two. You back, DJ?
I think so.
Okay. One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you.
Oh, you
live like a monkey. You smell like one, two.
Thank you, thank you, everyone. I appreciate it.
Singing online is impossible.
Yeah, right. One day, one
okay,
day.
Okay, so who's doing announcements today?
I'm not sure. I don't know if Pastor Zach is doing it. We shall find out.
Okay.
Oh, great.
Yeah,
this guy's
just
here.
chilling out on DJ's birthday, and yeah.
This guy's here.
And just get some hypeness and everything, and make sure you follow our social medias, and
you're here.
Our Twitch and YouTube, and go to www.vrchurch.org to go to our Discord and talk to awesome people like me. And
I'm
really
sitting on my couch
in my
living room
right
now.
We're probably interrupting Aaron's live stream.
Oh, Andy, you good?
Who cares? There's no one watching right now.
You don't know that. There probably is.
I think so.
Make sure to say hi to all Twitch viewers.
Oh yeah, did you get the, did you have to do the update?
I had to do the update, and the last two weeks I've had to sign in.
Yeah, it logged me out, so I had to re-log in.
Yeah. So I was going through and linking it to my Microsoft.
Wait, Allspace had an update?
Yes, Allspace had an update.
Didn't know that. Okay.
Yeah. So I think I got it linked to my Microsoft account now, so it should be easier logging in from now on.
Whoa!
So
cool.
Whoa, what?
We're good.
What happened?
What are you doing?
Nothing. Hey, Star.
What's up?
Am I, like, imagining things, or did I just see a boat just go around?
Jeez.
Yep, you see a boat.
Okay.
Oh, there's a boat.
Where's the boat?
That is interesting. So you're feeling a little better now?
Yeah, I am. And then if something's coming back, I don't know. I'm doing like a little flu or something. It's just kind of been up and down. So I started out the day really good. I was like, oh, I'm better. And then, but a little bit this afternoon, I was like, oh boy, better lay down for a bit.
Yeah, I had something like that not too long ago.
CJ?
Oh.
Had allergies about a week and a half ago. And then it kind of turned into quite a sore throat.
Oh, boy.
But it wasn't too bad.
And the man, Chad, hello, what's up?
Good morning.
Not much. I'm on a different account. Oops.
Oh, yeah, I was about to say. I recognize it.
Because I have to sign in when I come in into alt space. But,
hey, Marco. Yeah, it makes sense.
Hey, Ron. Oh, yeah. Face toward the screen.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, DJ.
Hey, what's up, Steven? Happy birthday.
Hey, thank you so much. Hello, my friends. We're going to get started with the worship. All right, guys, come on in, grab a seat, and let's begin. Hey everyone, welcome to VR Church. It's so good to see you. Whatever the part of the world you're from, I just want to say hello. It's good to be back. I've been sick for, I don't know, it seems like about 10 days, and something's still kind of lingering about today. I got up today. I was like, man, it's going to be good. I think I'm over it. And then about halfway through the day, I was like, oh boy, I better go lay down a bit. So a long way of saying, I might just get it right after service. I might just head out to go get some rest. I usually like to hang out in prayer world. So if you don't see me, that's where I am continuing my recovery. It's not COVID. Took a COVID test. So just to double check on that. But so anyways, enough about me. It's so good to see you guys and gals from all over the world. I don't know what part of the world you're from, but I do want to say welcome and hello. It's so good to see everyone. We're in the middle of a new series in the book of James. And we've just been kind of going chapter by chapter through that. And we're going to get going through that in a second. I want to, if you ever see me look to my right randomly and pointing, it's the Twitch chat that I have up. What's up, Twitch? Maisie Love, Crystal, what's up? And happy, oh, thank you. Happy belated. Thank you for the birthday wishes. Happy birthday, Crystal. Is it your birthday too, Crystal? Is it? I might have missed that. Our host on Twitch. Is that your birthday? Somebody let me know that on the Twitch. On the 6th, happy belated to you, Crystal. Happy birthday. All right. Very good. All right, well, let's do a couple of announcements here. We're in the middle of season 4 of Love, Prayer, and Destiny. Season 5 is coming up. So basically what that means is we're going to have a vision night coming up very soon. I don't know if it'll be the end of August, or it's probably going to be the middle of September. Vision night to let everyone know what's going on around all across the churches of VRMMO. There's a lot of things going on. There's a lot of things we'd like to do in the future. And so we're going to have big vision night. And we'll do it one Sunday on probably in September. And it'll be the same presentation across all the churches to let the whole church know what's going on. So in one way to look at it is that we are one church in many metaverses. And so one big vision update on what's going on. And I'm really looking forward to that. We've been planning and thinking about season 5 coming up and all that's going on. I think you're going to be really interested. Last year, It really opens up everyone's eyes to see all that's happening all across our ministry. Because oftentimes I tell people that VR Church isn't just a singular church. You just come in and this is one church or one church event. There's multiple churches across so many places. So Vision Night's coming, and that's season 4. Let's go to the next slide. That's going to be leading up to season 5. And one thing we've said from the very beginning, and this remains true, is that everyone is welcome, even if you don't believe in God. So if you're atheist, agnostic, you are free to come hang out, ask questions, be a part of the community. We have people from all types of faith traditions, Presbyterian, Catholic, you know, Baptist, all of that. So we just want to have respect and love for one another in our conversations. And so that's one thing to keep in mind. Everyone is welcome. Excuse me. So a couple of websites to keep in mind. One is our church website at vrchurch.org, especially if this is your first time. You're like, whoa, I'm wrapping my brain around what's going on here. Is this a real church, real pastors? Absolutely. A lot of info for you at vrchurch.org. Check that out, as well as our Twitch channel. That's where we have a lot of our videos. They also go to YouTube, but if you want to catch it live, we are live on Twitch at the moment. So definitely check out our Twitch channel and our website. And then at the bottom left, it says join our Discord server. That's a great idea. If you haven't done that, would love for you to do that as well. Next slide. As we have talked about, VR Church, it hasn't changed its name. So we're still VR Church, but we also have another ministry called MMO Church. And by the way, we'll update you all that on Vision Night. But we do have one Discord now. It's called the VR MMO Church Discord. All our churches there. So once you join the Discord, you'll see all that's happening there. And let's go to the next slide. And finally, one thought that we have that we never want to lose sight of, and this is just really important, and maybe the most important thing of today, is that we remember that this church is founded on love. It's God's love for us, our love for God, and our love for each other. That's really the most important thing. We could do 20 more churches. We could have 10,000 people. We can do this. We can do that. But if we don't have love at the core, then it's nothing. And that's what we receive from 1 Corinthians 13. You can have the tongue of men and angels. You can give your body to be burned and become a martyr. But if you don't have love, then it's nothing. And then at the end of the chapter, the writer says, three things are going to last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. And that's what we never want to forget. We don't want to get caught up in church, playing church, getting busy with church. We want to be caught up in our love for one another and good works towards one another. And we'll talk about that more in this sermon today. All right, well, I think that's the last slide. We're going to go into worship. And then, I'm excited to talk about James chapter 3 today. So, yeah, let's take some time to worship.
Do it all you can do. With one word, the mountains move. When you breathe, the dead arise, and the bones come back to life. There is power in this room, where the Spirit of the Lord is.
Everybody. Let's jump right into the sermon for today. We're started the book of James just recently, and just going chapter by chapter through the Bible, if this is your first time here. That's our style of church, just to read one chapter every week. And we're on James chapter 3 right now. And it's been just a really good series, very practical, gets to the heart of things right away. Pastor Zach, thank you so much for preaching the past couple Sundays as well. And there's just a lot to learn from James. And the things that he's been presenting to us, the writer has some really powerful things and really some powerful things for us today as well. And, you know, in chapter one, and I'm just giving a quick, simple overview, I definitely encourage you to go back and read James chapter one or two, or watch the live streams. on demand, so you could get caught up. But well, you definitely won't be missing too much as we jump into here. But in James chapter 1, we see the writer just kind of jump right into endurance, the ability to endure. Remember that moment in Dark Knight where Bruce Wayne looks to Alfred and goes, "What would you have me do?" I mean, it was like the pit of despair. He was being defeated by his enemies. And Alfred said, "Endure." And it was just that kind of a beautiful, stark moment in that Dark Knight trilogy. And that's what the writer is saying in chapter one. You're going to go through some things, man. You are going to go through some things that will bring strong men and women down to your knees. I wish life wasn't like that. I wish there was always a breakthrough, always a deliverance. But sometimes the storm doesn't go away. God's going to see you through the storm. And in that, we see this idea of letting it happen, letting it grow, let your endurance grow. And why would God do that anyway? Why am I going through the thick of it? Why is it like hell on earth? Isn't there enough problems? You know, I got, you know, problems at work and school, and, you know, what's the deal? You know, not everything's from God, by the way. Let me just kind of do a little asterisk. Not everything you go through is God, you know, as if God's punishing you all the time. But there is this aspect in that particular chapter where he was developing you to become stronger, a refiner's fire, to develop muscles and tenacity, the ability to withstand and endure, and to grow stronger and stronger in your spirit, to become unstoppable. Some of you are like, man, I feel like the last thing from Unstoppable. But no, if you don't realize it, behind the scenes, God is developing a strength in you, a tenacity and an endurance that's going to never quit, man. And then as you grow, the storms come again and you're like, what was that? You know, something, little fly hit me. You know, what used to like take you down and knock you off for days ain't going to do nothing anymore. Because what God's doing through these storms, through these difficulties, is he's developing your endurance. Oh man, I could go to stay on chapter one for a while, but you know, in chapter two, we see he's saying, talking about true religion. True religion isn't about theology and knowing this and knowing that. It's about taking care of the widows and the orphans. And we see this principle of doing good works towards others and showing love towards others. And by the way, there's many other principles. I'm just kind of giving you just an overview. And I watched last week, Zach. I thought it was great and powerful. And some of the stories you shared were very powerful. But let's continue growing in this faith and this knowledge. And let's go read James chapter 3. You probably were wondering, like, what is happening here? Is this a glitch? Why is there a boat out of control circling the world? All right, so we're going to talk about that. It's actually intentional. Some things we want to look at. And it'll probably be a little bit of a shorter of a sermon today, so we'll have some time to hang out in prayer world a bit. And I could use some help reading. So let me turn on participation. If people don't mind reading in public, you can go to your bottom right-hand HUD, and there's a button that says raise hands. And so that'll help me out as I'm a little something in my throat going on. But I'll start us out. Twitch, you doing okay? Hope everyone's doing good there. All right. And let's jump right in. Chapter 3, controlling the tongue. Let's talk about this. There's some really powerful things. I don't know if anybody in here is like, man, I have a hard time keeping my mouth shut because that person I just want to strangle and all that social media comment, let me get in there. And so James is actually going to enlighten our minds, our spirits, to the realization of the power of our words. The things that we say have such a drastic effect. That's not just words. It's not just things what we say. We can really build up or tear down. And so James is encouraging us to go counterculture in a culture that's just unkind, just cuts to the throat, knife to the throat type of comments, disregards people. And it's easy to go that path because, man, people can be frustrating, right? And, you know, but James is encouraging us to go a different route, to have a different mindset, to go counterculture to this. So let me start it out. It says here, dear brothers and sisters, that's you and me. Dear brothers and sisters, not many of you should become teachers in the church, for we who teach will be judged more strictly. You know, so that's an admonition. And so I don't know if for James and who he was talking to. Maybe there was like everyone was trying to get up there and preach, and he was saying, you know, not everyone can be teachers. And then he says this, indeed, we all make many mistakes. Anybody feel that? Like, Pastor, that's my middle name. But he says this, for if we could control our tongues, we would be perfect and could also control ourselves in every other way. That's a mind-blowing statement James just dropped right there in front of us. He says, if we can control the way we speak, we control the words that come out of our mouth, we would be perfect and could control ourselves in any other way. Now, let's talk a little bit about what that, so kind of bookmark that in your brain. Now, let's develop this idea. So let me have someone read verses 3 and 4, if you don't mind. Wandering, I'll see you there, if you don't mind reading 3 and 4.
Okay, can everyone hear me?
Yep,
can you hear me? We can make a large horse go wherever we want, just by means of a small bit in its mouth. A small rudder makes a huge ship turn wherever the pilot chooses to go, even though the winds are strong.
All right, thank you so much, Wandering. You know, we can make a large horse go wherever we go. Now, if you come and look at these horses, man, these are might be bigger than real life, but I kind of like it here. And we have some people at VR Church that own some horses, and maybe you do as well, or maybe you ride, or the stable, or whatever. Isn't it wild to think? I never really thought of it. I've rode in a horse, but this verse highlights it in my brain. You're on this beast that's several times larger than you, but you can make it go where you want to go. Like, that's kind of like mind-blowing. Maybe we just got used to the idea of controlling and riding horses. But if you actually think about it, we can make a large horse go wherever we want. And how do we do it? It's just this little bit in the mouth. It's this little thing that can control a large animal. So you can see what's happening here. The writer is painting a picture. There's some imagery he wants us to have in our minds. And then look at this big ship over here. You see it going kind of around the world. It's going behind there. And then what Wandering just read, what about a huge ship? The winds are super strong. You got a huge ship. Man, what's controlling that? This little bitty rudder in the back is controlling how it turns, even when the winds are strong. You know, there it goes. Look at the size of that ship. And look at the rudder in the back. I mean, percentage-wise, it's a very, very small percentage of the ship. But man, you can get into some big accidents. Have you seen that on TikTok or YouTube, with ships kind of like big ships trying to careen through like a narrow passageway and sometimes colliding? And, you know, it's all because the little rudder in the back worked or didn't work, or the pilot used it wrong or whatever. And so, again, he wants us to put this imagery of these large horses that we're able to control. In your mind, put your image of controlling this massive boat. It's just a little rudder. So what's the point of all that? Well, let's read what he says. Let's have someone read this whole column, 5 and 6, and see here. Leanne, if you don't mind reading 5 and 6, that one column right there.
Okay. In the same way that the tongue is a small thing that makes grand speeches, but a tiny spark can set a great forest on fire. And among all the parts of the body, the tongue is a flame of fire. It is a whole world of wickedness corrupting your entire body. It can set your whole life on fire, but it is set on fire by hell itself.
Wow. Yeah, thank you so much, Lee. Man, such powerful words and such powerful imagery. So we have horses that we control. We have a massive ship that we can direct. We have this little tiny spark that creates a forest fire. Have you seen in the news those forest fires that, you know, throughout, you know, the year? And how was that started? Just a little spark, and that created a massive forest fire. And then what Leanne just read, in the same way, do you have all those pictures in your mind? In the same way, the words that we say to each other has a powerful effect. Man, if you really think about it, like we've been thinking about the horse and the fire and the boat, words have started wars. Wars have created alliance. Words have created divorce. Words have started marriages. from just this little thing in our mouth, this little tongue, these words that come out of our mouth, the writer is saying they're just not words. There's power behind what we say. And the way we talk to each other, the way we respond to each other, you know, we let the emotions get the better of us and we say something. And well, maybe it's not a big deal because what we said isn't that harmful. But man, when we say negative things towards each other, whether it's audibly or perhaps on social media, man, it is ugly on social media sometimes, isn't it? He is saying, just like a horse, just like a ship, just like a forest fire, the little tongue has a powerful effect in our lives. And I believe the writer is trying to help us to understand that when we speak, let's be speaking words of life. So let's break this down a little bit. All right. So in the same way, the tongue is a small thing that makes grand speeches. Ever been inspired by an amazing speech? I mean, politician in a movie. I mean, like, I'm a sucker for like grand speeches in movies, you know, Leonidas in the 300, and, you know, Gandalf has a couple of great speeches that he makes. I mean, Aragorn back to Lord of the Rings, he does that, you know, the hearts of men may fail, but not today. And you're like, oh yeah, I'm not even, this is a fantasy thing and I'm pumped up, ready to go, right? And so it's amazing, even in a fictional setting, the power of the words that people say. It can make grand speeches. But a tiny spark can set a great forest fire. Now look carefully at this. And among all the parts of the body, the tongue is a flame of fire, and it can be cutting. It can really burn people. So if we have to be very careful to our friends, our family, people we that irritate us, you know, I don't know, at the gas station, at the store or whatever, at work, and I know you just want to ring that person, your tongue is a flame, can be a flame of fire. It can have a drastic effect. It is a whole world of wickedness corrupting your entire body. You can set your whole life on fire, for it is set on fire by hell itself. The language of hell versus the language of heaven. Now, let's take this a little bit of a step further, but not further than scripture, because the scripture is presenting something very interesting here. I've been talking about how we respond to each other, how we talk, the words that come out of our mouth. But the scripture is also saying here, the way you talk to yourself. Some of us are jerks to our own self. Look what it says here very carefully. It's a whole world of wickedness corrupting your entire body. It can set your whole life on fire. So there's two parts to it. It's the way we affect others with our words, and then the things that we say to ourselves. And some of us are jerks to our own self. We think we're worthless. We say we're no good. We can't do it. We're of no worth or value, we're ugly, we're this, we're that. And the scripture is saying, just as you would not want to speak negatively towards others, the words that you say to yourself, even if it's subconscious, maybe you're not verbally saying it, you're dumb, you're stupid, you're never gonna, but maybe it's subconscious, the scriptures are saying you can really destroy your life. You can really hurt your own self, like self-harm. And so, man, the writer is this, you know, I know it's strong language, I know it's like really pointed, perspective that he's bringing here, but it's for a purpose, because he wants us to live this life of love. He wants us to live this life that's blessed and not have cursings that are tearing down and burning each other, and not tearing down and burning your own self. So some of us are like, you know, I don't treat other people wrong. I don't say other wrong things to other people, but now, do you say that to your own self? And the scripture is saying you got to flip that script. You are beautiful. You are handsome. You are worthwhile. You do have value. You are more than enough. You are able. You are a champion. I don't know, whatever you have to say. I love what my kids said. I don't know, I think where this came from, but my kids put on my dresser this guy with a funny smile. It's supposed to be me and some funky hair. And it says, "You're looking good." You know, and some of us kind of need to do that. You know, we've been cutting ourselves up for so long. You got to look in the mirror and say, and you're looking good today. You're looking real sharp. You know, that's not arrogance. That's not conceit. That's just building yourself up with the words that you say. And so it's a great warning here. All right, so let's go over here. He wants to develop the idea more. Let's get this imagery more in our mind to understand this. Ben, if you don't mind reading. The next column, 7 through 9.
People can tame all kinds of animals, birds, reptiles, and fish, but no one can tame the tongue. It is restless and evil, full of deadly poison. Sometimes it praises our Lord and Father, and sometimes it curses those who have been made in the image of God.
Mm. Wow, that's powerful. And then let me turn off this. There we go. All right, thank you so much, Ben. I really appreciate that. So just like Ben was saying, we can tame all sorts of animals, like birds and reptiles and fish. It's pretty wild, you know, to see a tame dolphin and what mankind is able to tame as far as the animal kingdom is concerned, but the tongue. And by the way, I don't have to convince you. You have experienced it. People have said negative, ugly things to you. Hopefully, you know, you don't experience that at home, but maybe some of you do at home. You've heard that from family members, from friends, negative cutting words. And the tongue can't be tamed. It's full of deadly poison. And in one sense, and I don't know that he's saying this exactly, but he kind of alludes to it here in a couple of verses. He's like, man, pick a side. He says, are you going to be blessed or you're cursing? You can't do both. Don't live this life of this one mouth that's able to bless and curse with the same mouth. And so, yeah, here's where he says that. Let's see, get another reader here. Anybody else want to read? I don't see anybody on the list. I can read if there's no one wants to read here. Oops, Marco, I accidentally cut you out. Go ahead and raise your hand again. I'll go ahead and read this one. And Marco, go ahead and raise your hand. And so blessing and cursing come pouring out of the same mouth. Surely, my brothers and sisters, this is not right. Does a spring of water bubble out with both fresh water and bitter water? Does a fig tree produce olives or a grapevine produce figs? No. And you can't draw fresh water from a salty spring. So there's things that we just know to be true. Like he's painting this picture of the fig tree of water. You know, you can't have salty and fresh at the same time. You can't have a fig and olives at the same, or fig tree produce olives or grape vine produce figs. It just doesn't work. And so again, there's this imagery for us out of our mouth, the controlling our tongue, not to have those two worlds of blessings and cursings coming out of the same mouth towards others and towards ourselves. All right, let's come all coming over here. And just a few more verses. Marco, if you don't mind reading 13 through 16. So those two columns right there.
I'm sorry, from 13 to 16?
Yep, these two columns, yep.
If you are a wise and understand God's ways, prove it by living an honorable life, doing good works with the humility that comes from wisdom. But if you are bitterly jealous and there's selfish ambitions in your heart, don't cover up the truth with boasting and lying. For jealousy and selfishness are not God's kind of wisdom. Such things are earthly, unspiritual, and demonic. For wherever there is jealousy and selfish ambition, there you will find disorder and evil of every kind.
All right. Thank you so much, Marco. Appreciate that. And a couple of things to highlight here. I love that it says, prove it. Prove it. Let me show me the money. You've seen that, I think it's Tom Cruise and Cuba Gooding Jr. Show me the money. Let me see the proof. You know, and in the same way, the writer is saying, show me that you're living this life of blessing and of love. And Pastor Zach alluded to that, or didn't allude, he did a great, you know, presentation about, you know, faith without works is dead. Like, let me see your faith in action. And so if you're wise and understand God's ways, prove it by living an honorable life. And then underline that word in your brain, doing good works. And that's something that we want to definitely highlight, bookmark, elevate in our lives, doing good works, speaking good towards others. Hey, man, you did a good job on that presentation of the other day. Hey, well, I really appreciate how, you know, you're always on time and you always work hard. You know, just good works is also the good things that we say out of our mouth. And he says, but on the other side is like things like jealousy, selfish ambition, selfishness. And so he says, this is two different worlds, and the world he's calling us to live in is the one of light and love. All right, I don't see any other hand readers, so I'll go ahead and finish this off right here. Now, he's presented this whole truth, and now here's the ideal. Here's what we're striving for. Here's what we're setting our sights on. Let's read this very carefully. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure. It is also peace-loving. I love that two words together, peace and loving, peace-loving. Gentle at all times. I know that can be tough sometimes. And willing to yield to others. You might be right, by the way, whatever situation it is, whatever argument, whatever thing, you might be right. But there is this idea of yielding to others, backing up, showing humility and grace. Doesn't mean, I think sometimes this, people can take it too far to be like getting tramped on at work or just getting abused. You know, that I don't think it's the things that we're talking about, because willing to yield also has this idea of strength behind it, or meekness. And so that's something to keep in mind there. So the wisdom from above is first of all pure, is also peace-loving, gentle at all times, and willing to yield to others. It is full of mercy. It's full of it. And the fruit of good deeds. It shows no favoritism and is always sincere. And I know we might read this and go, "Ooh," you know, kind of, you know, wipe the sweat off our brow. That's a hard to live up to. But, you know, the writer's encouraging us to set your sights on this. This isn't like a, let's throw you guilt out here for all of us not attaining this. It's more of a, let's be encouraged and empowered to set our sights on this type of living. We're not doing the blessing and cursings out of the same mouth. We're not doing that. We're doing something completely different. And this is the wisdom that how God wants us to live. So this is a great, like if you're reading the book of James with us, chapter by chapter through each week. And this is one great to highlight, great to write down, great to think on. This is the ideal that you want to have in your mind. And that's great. I think that's powerful. And all those who are peacemakers, if you're a peacemaker, that's us. If all those who are peacemakers will plant seeds of peace, you'll plant those seeds and reap a harvest of righteousness. So don't be discouraged. Don't feel guilty. But this is what the writer, this is what God is calling us to. This is the ideal we set our eyes towards. And so that's James chapter 3, kind of a shorter chapter there. But that leaves us time for some Q&A. Maybe you have a question about one of the passages of scripture here, or maybe from the other chapters before. Or maybe you have a comment. Maybe something stood out to you. And you just wanted to make a comment about that. So if you do, on your bottom right hand says raise hand. Feel free to raise your hand. And we'll take a minute or two. And I'll check the Twitch chat while you guys are thinking to see if there's any questions on the Twitch. Oh, more happy birthdays. Thank you. Appreciate it. Excellent. All right. If there's no questions, we'll close in prayer for today. Let's see here. Let me check Twitch. See if anybody has any questions or comments. Okay. All right. Let's close in a word of prayer. God, I just want to pray for everyone in here. I just pray that you'd help us with the words that come out of our mouth to realize how powerful they are. And to others and to ourselves, maybe people are really speaking negatively to ourselves. God, help us to flip the script. Help us to take a new mindset. Help us to shift into this ideal that you've called us to be peacemakers, to plant seeds of peace, to harvest righteousness. God, help us to yield to others. Help us to just to be a different kind of person in this world that's just in turmoil, it seems like. And help us to go counterculture to what we see and to be a blessing to others. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, everybody. All right. closes the service for today. We're going to head over to Prayer World for a bit. Starfire. Starfire here? Let's see. Starfire. Zeke is here. All right. I'll do the Starfire bit. So we're going to go to Prayer World. So click on this portal. Just click once, or if you click twice, it'll unconnect you to it. So at the top of the hill, feel free to hang out, chat. We'll just be there chilling. But there's this little arch. If you go past the arch, the prayer team will be back there. And if you need prayer, go to the prayer arch, and we can. The prayer team will be down there to pray for you. So like Zeke, and who else? I think, is it just Zeke today? No, Carrie is out. Oh, thank you, Papa. I'll definitely be trying to feel better. Starfire might be. Carrie's here. Oh, Carrie's here. So Carrie. So Toe, that's my wife. And let's see, Zeke and anybody else that is on the team. I think it's it. So good. And as I was doing this, I realized, oh, my kids got me an Apple Watch. It's really nice for my birthday. I was just looking at that. It's really nice. And I'm looking at my VR hand, but I can feel it. And so, you know, there's kind of like this sadness as a father to see your babies and your little kids grew up to like teenagers. But then there's that nice side where, you know, they got jobs and they're bringing in nicer gifts. It's like, oh, this Apple Watch is pretty fantastic. All right. Let's keep making the monies. So I'm just kidding. All right. Thanks, everybody. We can launch Prayer World, and yeah, we'll see you next week. James chapter 4. Next week.